6-second sound bites and an unwillingness to talk about real issues in a serious way. For example, climate change. I have to write a letter to the presidents of all of the networks to tell them that I'm going to sign the show for them.
That's why I'm fucking with these bitches. These numbers in my phone, a text pops up, she's like, who is this? You probably got a mistress, probably every week it switches. Now is this cause for concern, and should I be suspicious? I'm overseas tripping, a million miles away, and she's still in LA. My mom's out in the bay, and he's all
from Kansas. Chris Matthews is waiting to talk to us from his studio. Chris, I believe you're at floor level, bringing all the excitement right to you.
Right.
The tax code for the benefit of the people he serves.
Well, there's no one who's shown more genius in their way to maneuver around the tax code. This is actually a very, very good story for Donald Trump.
I love how Chris Christie sounds like he believes that. Like, no, because no one's that good a liar. It's like he Jedi mind tricked himself. He was just like, this is a good story.
I've spent time with grieving mothers who've lost their children, laid off workers whose jobs have gone to other countries, and people from all walks of life who just want a better future. I have gotten to know the great people of our country, and I've been humbled by the faith they placed in me.
I was just coming up with an idea for you.
I will never, ever.
Steak was doing her job and greeting the adolescent boner boss.
Your girl's hot as shit.
Whoa.
Yes.
Whoa.
Yes, the Donald is good.
Whoa.
Oh, my man. Look at those legs. All I can see is the legs.
No, it looks good.
Come on, shorty.
Speech there tonight, and in just the last hour, a brand new look at the state of the race. According to a newly released USA Today Suffolk University poll, Hillary Clinton now leads.
Running a relay, you do your very best, and then you pass off the baton, and you just hope that the person you pass it off to doesn't drop to the ground or doesn't turn around and run back the way we came from, which is what my opponent is promising. I told the president that when he hands off the baton, he's going to have to bend over. He's a lot taller than I am. But I'm excited about what we can do. I know this has been a tough campaign. I've got people coming up to me saying they've got migraines they never had before. They have stomach aches.
Truth. Lies instead of reality. Lies instead of life. And yet with all these lies, biggest lie of the weekend nearly flew under everybody's radar. It is impossible to say for sure just how far you would go to punish undocumented Americans. You've already insisted millions of them will be deported. There are laws in the books right now about what happens to immigrants, even those who have become naturalized citizens, if they have lied in any way to gain citizenship. But the government rarely pursues these liars unless they are somehow involved in war crimes or terror.
Love, but I have perfected it.
What the fuck is this?
And you can tell what a wonderful human being I am just by the hate and the lies that the media say about me. Aren't I precious?
Thank you.
straight all the way back as far as you can go.
Oh, yeah.
I can't. No.
Huge magnitude. Of course, she was holding the event here at the Javits Center, which has
but there's still a chance. Why'd she do that?
No.
But it was not to be again.
Sense? Anybody's think it makes sense that 52% of all new income is going to the top 1%? I don't think people do. And they're sitting there and they're saying, we don't want more of the same old, same old. Trump comes along and he says, I, a multi-billionaire, I don't pay any taxes. Yeah, I got companies in Turkey and Mexico and China, but I am going to stand up to the economic establishment. I'm going to stand up to the political establishment. I'm going to take them all on. And I think a lot of people responded, okay, we'll give this guy a shot.
Yeah, I'm sorry. This is...
Listen to these motherfuckers. You know how they say the Russians are coming over here? Hey, gosh, shit! Haha! Surprise! Uh-oh, this fucker's tough. Come on, motherfucker, I ain't got no day. This song is for the Russians! This is called...
Right there to the left is Centennial Olympic Park, and to the right is the base of the big Ferris wheel that they have there now. So that gives you a reference point as folks are traveling toward the Phillips Arena there to travel around and maybe head back up. Peachtree would be one way for these folks to march. We shall wait and see, but this was stretching all the way down.
That's how we begin the panel discussion. Now, what do you have to say?
I mean,
top that.
I don't think. It strikes me every morning when I wake up that we're waking up in a country in which the President of the United States is under investigation by the FBI for possible collusion with a foreign adversary, as stated by the director of the FBI in open congressional testimony, which is just.
Before Congress in exchange for immunity. In a statement today, Flynn's attorney said, quote, General Flynn certainly has a story to tell, and he very much wants to tell it, should the circumstances permit. Phil Ewing is NPR National Security Editor. He's with us now. Hi, Phil.
Hey, how's it going?
It's going well.
FBI and Capitol Hill sources, and it was said by who? Carl Bernstein. Being dead right about Watergate 44, 45, and 46 years ago does not mean he is automatically right about Trump and Russia, but it does mean Carl Bernstein's reporting gets a faster and more durable benefit of the doubt than anybody else's. And while Bernstein underscored that there yet may prove to be nothing to the Trump-Russia links, the unalterable fact of history is that Richard Nixon was forced from office not by the Watergate break-in, but by the Watergate cover-up. People went to jail during the infamous Teapot Dome scandal, not because of the oil, but because of the cover-up. They got
too many matters related to Hillary Clinton that may have arisen during the campaign, either from what it looks like, which is that this is about Trump-Russia, or from what they say it's about, which is that this is about Hillary Clinton and the emails. He should be recused in either case. Are we just putting too much emphasis on the word recused? Does it not really mean anything?
No, it's supposed to mean something. The entire process is a farce. Both of those memos are a farce. Look at the dates of the memos, both dated today. Let me tell you, the way the Department of Justice works, it's deliberate. It's slow. If this was Ron Rosenstein's idea, he would have worked on it.
That seems like an extraordinary use of influence to try
shut down an investigation being done by the FBI. I don't know if it's true yet.
And Jason Chaffetz, who has subpoena power as the chairman of the Oversight Committee tonight, saying that he is drafting the necessary paperwork to get the Comey memo. He says, I want to read the memo.
Went right back to the issue of hacking. You had said for months that Russia had nothing to do with the interference of the American election, and then this week you floated the idea of patriotic hackers doing it. Why the change, and why now?
I hadn't said anything. It's just that French journalist asked me about those hackers. I told him the same thing I can tell you. Hackers can be anywhere. They can be in Russia, in Asia, even in America.
And her dealings with Russia, and would be very useful to your father, talking about Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, end quote, and Donald Trump, end quote. And more than that, the emails indicate that Donald Trump Jr. was told in advance with or representing the Russian government. As for that attorney, he met with my colleague Keir Simmons, who tracked her down in Moscow in an exclusive interview. She denied any connection with the Kremlin, but in apparent contradiction to what Donald Trump Jr. has said, the attorney says the premise for the meeting was to discuss sanctions.
Big beautiful wall. Goddamn. Donald Trump would be the worst person to go into hiding because he would probably change his appearance, but we'd still know that it was him. We would still know it was him. I hope Twitter buys extra service tonight because going down, people, this Mueller grand jury thing just caps off, honestly, a terrible day for Donald Trump. Because
they missed the old Drake girl. Don't tempt me if they don't get it. Oh, that new shit that you got is old. You better do what you're supposed to do.
Hello, I'm in Berlin today. I have a screening, and apparently, according to texts I'm getting, Mueller is filing charges, and people are going to be arrested on Monday. This is huge.
Which is exactly what's happening here, and we haven't even talked about Bob
Corker. Berlin.
Yeah. You know, Joe, it's hard to measure moments like this in terms of history, because history is such a long haul. But it's not hard to measure this moment in terms of what is going on right now within the Republican Party. This is a slow slide of principled conservatism among Republicans that has been an honorable part of your party for many, many years. A slow slide of that principled conservatism into something that resembles a dumpster fire. I mean, what people...
to some of the children.
Who likes this? Well, you have no weight problems. That's the good news, right?
You have no weight problems. I can't wait to see how Trump botches the presidential turkey pardon. You're gonna live, but the rest of your family dead. They're all dead.
So they're making sure to leave rooms if the subject of Russia comes up. The article, the Vanity Fair article, goes on to say President Trump is increasingly pointing fingers at his son-in-law and senior advisor Jared Kushner, quote, again, Speaking to Steve Bannon on Tuesday, Trump blamed Jared Kushner for his role in decisions, specifically the firings of Mike Flynn and James Comey, that led to Mueller's appointment, according to a source briefed on the call. When Roger Stone recently told Trump that Kushner was giving him bad political advice, Trump agreed, according to someone familiar with the conversation. Again, this is from Vanity Fair. Former Trump campaign aide Sam Nunberg is quoted in the article.
Always in control. And that's what we've got to do, is wait on God, let this process play out. So I can't help but wonder, is God really going to save Roy Moore's candidacy? No way, Jose!
Yeah, didn't the RNC tell Moore that they weren't going to pursue it?
Out of office, he looked exactly what he's going through. He looked like the guy going through what he's going through, abruptly dethroned from a prestigious position he thought he owned. The president didn't do it to his face. He apparently called him, he just said a few hours ago, to make sure he knew it. But that was sort of a coup de grace more than a call to him to resign. And I thought it was interesting, he tried to win goodwill with the Department of State people and the Defense Department people. He has not had a great relationship with them.
Again, Robert Costa report. The special counsel told President Trump's attorneys that the president remains under investigation but is not a criminal target. Quote, in private negotiations in early March about a possible presidential interview, Mueller described Trump as a subject of his investigation into Russia's interference in our 2016 election. Prosecutors view someone as a subject when that person has engaged in conduct that is under investigation.
About everybody except the culprit. It's inexplicable. Well, maybe it's not. President Trump has blamed Secretary Clinton. He's blamed the DNC. He's blamed the FBI. He said that, quote, both countries are responsible for the state of relations between the United States and Russia. The one person he hasn't blamed is the person he stood shoulder to shoulder with this morning, Vladimir Putin.